Today we'll see the skeleton of the head, that is the skull. So the skull can be studied under two subheadings. One is the calvaria, which encloses the brain. The other one is the facial skeleton. So altogether you have 28 bones that forms a skull. Among this, the calvaria is composed of 14 bones and the facial skeleton is composed of 14 bones. These bones can be grouped as paired bones and unpaired bones. The paired bones of calvaria include the parietal bone on either side, the temporal bone on either side, and three paired ear ossicles, that is the malleus, incus, and stapes, which are the ear ossicles present in the middle ear. The unpaired bone of the calvaria includes the frontal bone, the sphenoid bone, the ethmoid bone, and finally the occipital bone. So the unpaired bone include the occipital bone, the sphenoid bone, the ethmoid bone, and the frontal bone, whereas the paired bone include the parietal, temporal, and the three paired ossicles, malleus, incus, and stapes. Going to the facial skeleton also 14 in number, and they also can be grouped as paired and unpaired bones. The paired bones of the facial skeleton include the maxilla on either side, the zygomatic bone on either side, the nasal bone on either side, the lacrimal bone, the palatine bone. And the inferior nasal concha. So again I repeat, the facial skeleton of paired bones are the maxilla, the zygomatic, nasal, lacrimal, palatine bone, and the inferior nasal concha. So going to the joints of the skull. So mostly the joints of the skull are suture. You have few primary cartilaginous joints also, and you have three pairs of synovial joints. Among this, the two pair of synovial joints are present between the ear ossicles, and one pair is the largest temporomandibular joint. Going to the sutures, so you have various types of sutures. You have plain suture, for example, between the internasal suture. Between the nasal bone, you have internasal suture, which is a plain suture. And you have a serrate suture, that is the... So between this, this is the serrate suture, which is the coronal suture, which is in serrated appearance, coronal suture. You have denticulate suture, which is the lambdoid suture. So here you have denticulate, so which forms a tooth-like projections. So this is the denticulate suture. And finally, you have the squamous suture. Squamous suture is between the squamous part of the temporal bone and the parietal bone. So this is the squamous suture. So the sutures of the skull are plain, that is the internasal suture, serrate suture, that is the coronal suture, and denticulate suture, that is the lambdoid suture and the squamous suture, the parietotemporal suture. So the skull can be studied by keeping the skull in the anatomical position. For this you have to know two lines. One is the Reed's baseline, the other one is the Frankfurt's horizontal plane. So what is Reed's baseline? So this line is a horizontal line which is obtained by connecting the infraorbital margin and the center of the external acoustic meatus. So connecting this two line is the Reed's baseline. So connecting the infraorbital margin and the middle of the external acoustic meatus is the Reed's baseline. The other line is the Frankfurt's horizontal plane. So the Frankfurt's horizontal plane is all obtained by connecting the infraorbital margin and the upper margin of the external acoustic meatus. So connecting these two will be the Frankfurt's horizontal plane. So this is the Frankfurt's horizontal plane. So by placing the skull in this horizontal plane, you can study the skull. The skull can be studied from outside or from externally in different view. So you can study the skull from the front, anterior view, or norma frontalis, or you can study the skull from the side or lateral view, norma lateralis. You can study the skull from behind or posterior view, that is norma occipitalis, and you can study the skull from above, that is the superior view, that is the norma verticalis, and you can study the skull from below, that is the inferior view, that is the norma basalis. So you can study the skull from inside after opening the skull cap or the cranial vault. So you can study the inside, the inner surface of the cranial vault and the internal surface of the cranial base, which has the anterior, middle and the posterior cranial fossa.